As we explore quantum body, quantum metabolism, quantum mind, quantum biology, then one thing becomes clear, and that is our mental activity, our metabolic activity, the depth and rate of our breathing, our heart rate variability, our parasympathetic and sympathetic nervous system, our cerebral cortex, our immune system, our endocrine system, our self-regulating mechanisms at a cellular and even quantum level are all entangled. So one of the practical applications of this is that our breathing, the rate and depth of our breathing can reflect both mental and metabolic activities simultaneously because they're entangled. Because they're entangled. When we are stressed, for example, or anxious, then our breathing becomes shallow and rapid. This is because the sympathetic nervous system, which is responsible for the fight or flight response, is activated. The sympathetic nervous system sends signals to the lungs to breathe faster, to deliver more oxygen to the muscles, and sends signals to the heart also to raise blood pressure and to speed up. On the other hand, we can also influence our mental activities through breathing as well. When we are relaxed, our breathing becomes slow and deep. This is because the parasympathetic nervous system, which is responsible for the rest and digest response, is activated. The parasympathetic nervous system sends signals to the lungs to breathe slower in order to conserve energy. Similarly, heart rate decreases, heart rate variability increases, etc., etc. We can also influence mental and metabolic activities through breathing. For example, slow breathing techniques such as diaphragmatic breathing can help reduce stress and anxiety. And always remember that when you breathe through the nose, breathing slows down, oxygenation is increased, nitrous oxide is added, the breath is humidified, it gets warm. So nasal breathing, slow breathing can help reduce stress and anxiety also. And of course, this is because the slow breathing activates the parasympathetic nervous system, which has a calming effect on the body and the mind. Slow breathing can also help to improve metabolic health. This is because slow breathing helps to lower blood pressure, heart rate, and blood sugar levels, even blood sugar levels. Additionally, slow breathing can help you to sleep, can help your sleep quality. There are many ways to influence mental and metabolic activities. Just a couple. Diaphragmatic breathing is a type of breathing that involves breathing from the diaphragm, which is the muscle that supports the chest and abdomen. To do diaphragmatic breathing, you can sit or lie in a comfortable position, place one hand on your chest, the other on your belly, and breathe slowly and completely with your abdomen, with your abdomen, with your, moving your diaphragm. So on the inhale, and the abdomen moves out, on the exhale, the abdomen moves in. There's something called box breathing that has become very popular, and this involves counting to four on each inhale and exhale. To do box breathing, you can sit or lie comfortably and close your eyes and breathe in slowly and count to four, breathe in, and then breathe out slowly and count to four. And you can do that for about 5 to 10 minutes. And then, of course, there's pranayama, alternate nostril breathing, ujjayi breathing, on and on. These things that we practice through pranayama. The basic understanding, though, which is very important, is metabolic activity, mental activity, perceptual activity, emotional activity, breathing, heart rate variability, every metabolic feedback loop, endocrine and immune is all happening simultaneously. It's entangled. It's a non-local correlation. It's quantum mechanical. At the most fundamental level, it is a causal, non-local, quantum mechanical interrelatedness, and it's the ground state of our being in choiceless awareness. Once we can get to that, then from there, we can direct attention and intention to any aspect of our biology. The easiest, of course, is the breath. And this is how we become masters and regulators of our own biology. Entangled activities at every level, quantum mechanical, structural, biochemical, physiological, anatomical. Let me know if this is helpful.